Kia ora, I'm Smitner, and I want to show you how I added eyes to my pixel-perfect procedural tentacle for my dark puzzle game, Aseprite. Check out the description for access to the source code. This is a follow-up on my previous video, linked somewhere. This video does include a sponsored advertisement. It will be clearly marked in the video chapters and on screen. Jumping straight in, let's take a look at Aseprite to build a basic understanding of the effect we're building. Essentially, we want to drag an eye sprite around to follow a target. And if we put the eyelid texture on top, the effect becomes pretty convincing. We'll also create a mask texture, which we'll use to cut the eye out. The black area will become transparent, leaving us with a round, at least in the pixel art world, eye. I use Aseprite, and I found this nice script to export all layers as individual sprites. We have a Sprite 2D with our eye sprite, and we've also added a canvas item shader. Using a target offset multiplied by the texture pixel size, we can modify the UV to effectively slide the eye texture. Every frame, the eye script calculates the relative distance between the mouse position and the eye and passes it into the shader. Given that we can pass in any offset value, we can shift the UV without limits. To get this under control, we can limit the length of the offset vector. To do this, we calculate the length of the target offset, determine the direction with the normalize function, and clamp it with the max distance parameter. To get the final offset, we multiply the direction unit vector by the clamped distance, making sure to use the round function to remove any decimal places. Now, keen-eyed viewers might notice we're doing a lot of redundant work. We're calling length and then normalize? How can we optimize this? A, replace the normalize call and calculate the direction using the offset divided by distance. B, it's perfect, it works, don't change it. C, move the offset clamping to GD script. Or D, use C sharp. Have a think about that while I tell you about my very first sponsor, Brilliant. That optimization question, that's the kind of thinking Brilliant is built around. Not memorizing formulas and copy-pasting questionable YouTube code, but building the intuition to figure out things for yourself. Brilliant helps you get better at math and computer science through visual, interactive problem solving. You learn by doing, working through problems until they actually click. It meets you where you are. Whether you're brushing up on coordinate math or diving deep into algorithms, the personalized teaching tailors lessons to your level and helps you advance at a comfortable yet challenging pace. There's a ton of courses to sink your teeth into, so try Brilliant free for 30 days at brilliant.org/smitner, scan the QR code or check the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off a premium subscription for unlimited daily access to everything. Got your answer? Let's narrow it down. Did you select A, replace the normalized call and instead divide the target offset by the distance, saving one square root calculation per frame? Or did you select C, move the offset clamping to GD script and pass it into the shader directly? If you selected C, good stuff. The clamped offset doesn't change across the sprite. It's the same for every pixel. So by doing the clamping in GD script, we significantly reduce our compute. In a 16 by 16 sprite, 256 pixels, we're removing 255 redundant square root calculations per frame. Back to it. As we explored in Aseprite before, we have three layers to this effect, the eye, the eyelid, and the mask. We sample the eyelid texture using our unshifted UV, and we use the mix function to combine them. To get the mask cutout applied, we modify the alpha channel to the inverse alpha of the mask. We're inverting the alpha channel because in Aseprite, we use transparent pixels to see the eye and opaque pixels to mark where we want the sprite to be cut out. To make this thing a little more organic, let's interpolate the eye's target over time. Each frame, we linearly interpolate the current target towards the new tracking target. This creates exponential easing, fast at first and slowing down as it approaches, never quite reaching its target. Here we have three eyes, but you may see an issue. Only the third eye tracks our target correctly. The problem is that by default, all three instances of our eye scene share the same shader material instance, and therefore the same target offset parameter is used. By checking resource local to scene, we tell Godot to duplicate that resource when the scene instantiates. Meaning, in this case, three instances of the shader material, which leads to three unique target offset parameters. Let's add some eyes to the tentacle we created in the previous video. If you haven't watched it yet, shame on you. First, we define a helpful eyeData internal class. This will store a reference to our eye and some position data. The tentacle class gets an addEye function that will instantiate the eye scene, find a valid segment, and alternate between left and right based on the current eye count. Every frame, we iterate over a collection of eyes, and using the segment index to get a direction between the two points in our tentacle, we calculate the perpendicular vector and determine the final position using our side and offset distance. Finally, using our API from the eye class, we set the target to focus on the tip of the tentacle. And that's it. A UV scrolling, layer compositing, smooth tracking, pixel perfect eye shader for our procedural pixel perfect art tentacle thing. Full source code is linked in the description with demo scenes, debug views, the entire works. If you want to see these creepy eyes in action, wishlist has a pay on Steam. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, do the thing. Till next time. The tentacle.